We're going to move into unconference mode, so... Thank you. I'll go back to the room. How many people are planning to do a pitch? All right, so here's how it's going to work. I've got, this is an upgrade from last year's city camp. We have pieces of paper that are formatted. It's just a better upgrade. I'm not a designer, but according to Jen, I am a designer. And I made this cool slide where you can put the name of your session and then your name. And we have some voting areas. So I'm going to leave these up here. I want folks who plan on pitching to come up here and stand in line, start filling these out. And what I'm going to do is go give you an example of what a good pitch might be. So I want you to come up and say your name. I want you to come up and kind of say your session title, and then you've got like 30 seconds to describe it. You're going to have 60 seconds total. So I need a timer. Leo, can you help me find a timer on the tablet? And where's Ian? Ian's our enforcer. All right, so thanks, guys. Come on up. So this is all organic. We didn't plan this part yet. So I'm gonna give you a sample. So basically, tell us kind of what your idea is, and if you're kind of have an idea of what you need help with, tell us what you need help with, right? So I'm gonna do a sample pitch. Hi everyone, my name is Jason Hibbets. I want to talk about how we take City Camp North Carolina beyond the triangle. Literally, I want to take it to all of North Carolina. So I want to have a discussion about how we can do that. That's my pitch. So it'd be really simple. If you go over a minute, we're just gonna cut you off. So so think about what you want to say, be very succinct, and we're gonna get going. So who's ready to do a pitch? Come on up and start a line. And I don't have any good jokes. Did you bring any good jokes? We'll get started in about, we'll give these folks about a minute and then we'll get started. I know Jen, you want to do
the food area.
And if this is your first time at City Camp, if you think you have an idea to do a pitch, get in line. By the end of it, I've had people come up to us at City Camp and they go, man, this is my first time. I wish I would have done a pitch. And they really regret it when they're sitting in the sessions later on after lunch. So what we're going to do, just while we're getting prepared here, we're going to do some pitches. Lunch is coming into the next room. When we are done with the pitches, we are going to line all the ideas along the front row, and we're going to have you vote on the sessions that you would attend. And so we're going to give everyone four votes. So you'll get four votes. When you vote, you can stack your votes. So if you really want one session, you can stack it all on one. I probably recommend you spread them out. This way we have some good stuff. Anyway, you can do it however you would like. All right. Is anyone, when you're ready, Chris, just gonna...
Jason?
Yeah.
50 seconds.
You have 50 seconds. So that's a new upgrade. We shaved off 10 seconds this year.
Sorry. Okay, my name's Chris Matthews. I talked about this last night, but right now I'm ready to formally pitching the GreenSTEM Network. I want to create IoT sensors to do gardens, and if you're interested in talking to that, come. We'll do a session. We'll figure out what we're going to do. We'll create a plan to create these sensors for the urban gardens in Raleigh. Thanks.
Hi, I'm Janet Danforth, and I basically want to talk to everybody and hopefully get people to come and talk about how do we get the word out to people that are not in this room. We all know about all the cool things that we're doing, but how do other people know about projects that everybody else is going to pitch? So come, we'll talk about how we can do that.
My name is Bill Scanlon, and I want to talk about improving access to critical information in restaurant inspections, building off of NC Food Inspector to include CDC risk factor data rather than just simply the numeric score of an inspection. Wake County's got the data available, in our portal to build off of that and present that information. So we want to look at that. We're looking at, we have some great design work done already. The data work is ready to go. We're looking for developers and people who eat at restaurants.
Hi, my name is Suzanne, and I'd like to have a conversation about how might we better deliver emergency services to those who need it. We've heard from a lot of different corners that there are various parts of our community that are not necessarily representative, they don't have access, and they don't know how to ask. When disaster strikes, how do we get to those? Let's have a conversation about it.
Pause 1 second for the corner. Pardon the interruption. If you are also going to be doing NC Data Palooza and you have a team, this is a great time to pitch an idea for your team as well.
Sorry. I'm Eric Jackson. I want to have a conversation about hacking from the inside. 3 years ago, I walked into my first Code for Agile meeting, got involved, now I'm one of the co-captains, but I also just recently started as digital services architect for the city of Asheville. And so I'm new in government. I'd just like to have a conversation with other people about how you do that hacking from the inside.
My name is Adam Martin. I'm the Open Data Program Manager for the City of Raleigh. I want to run a session. It's more of a discussion and a training session for these open data portals. So Open Data 101 for normies. So if you're not a developer, please, I think a lot of folks in this room are our target audience for data, but I have a suspicion that many of you actually haven't spent any time actually downloading data from our portal. So I want to make sure that you know how to do that and do some interesting things with it, and then get your feedback about how we can do it better.
I'm Jeremy Freeman with Code for Neuro, and we've been working on making access to the information about schools more accessible. And I'd like to open up a discussion on the NC School Monitor, where we can make accessible school performance data. You find the grades that are up there opaque, you know, it's public, it's opaque. I want to have a discussion on how we make it more open, accessible, and bring the principles of open data to the education system.
Hello. I'm Michael Feld, and I would like to run a session on analyzing demographic gerrymandering in North Carolina school districts.
Here's
that
mic.
That's Mike.
We'll give you extra time.
All right, thanks.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm Michael Pell, and I would like to run a session on analyzing demographic gerrymandering in North Carolina school districts. As you might have heard, it's going on at the political level, and believe it or not, it's happening with all other types of districts as well. I did a project earlier for School District of North Carolina, and I'd like to share how I did that and how we could take that technology and benefit the rest of the state.
Hi, my name is Sahana. I'm a high school junior, which is why I may look like a nervous wreck right now. But I'm here talking about Carpool Vote, which is a service that connects voters who don't have access to rides to polling stations, and we're in need of front-end and back-end developers for this project. So if anyone would like to have a discussion about that, that would be great. Thanks.
Not too bad. That was a great pitch.
So I'm Amy Gaskins, and I'm really interested in your opinions about how we can crowdsource weather data to start doing hyper-local weather prediction. So this is something that the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration and the private weather industry haven't been able to crack, but it's very useful data for emergency services, for government, and for industry.
Excellent. I'm Andrew Turner. I want to run a session generally on maps and geo, but how to be your own neo-geographer. So open source tools, easy to use tools to answer your own personal neighborhood questions with open data.
Hey everybody, I'm Sam McClenny. I wanted to have a discussion. For those of you who don't know, the Sunlight Foundation recently had a letter come out that said they're going to close down some programs, and it was kind of convoluted. And then also I know that Code for America Brigade's had trouble sustaining themselves as well around the nation, so I'd like to have a discussion about how to sustain civic tech and open data.
Hi, my name is Ken Hunter. I'm the budget manager for the city of Rocky Mount. For those of you don't know, we're about an hour or two your east here in Raleigh. And I'm here for those of you who are entrepreneurs. Anyone here want to create something for themselves to make a business out of? Okay. Well, there are a lot of first world problems that have already been solved. What I want to talk about is how communities like Rocky Mount that are outside of the Raleigh area who deal with a lot of challenges that areas like Raleigh don't do, how we have the opportunity to grow your entrepreneurial potential by being a laboratory for ideas, whether it's in coding or in other things. We do have something, it's something that we need to be able to grow our own economies, and something we would certainly open to you as an opportunity.
I'm John Stevens, civic tech by all the people. So I know this is an echo for Janet, so I'm happy to combine with that. And I'm specifically calling out Polkadot, who may have the same kind of idea as she finished her talk. So happy to combine with other proposals.
Hi there, Chris Matthews back again. And I'd also like to talk about creating a citizens data academy. Taking it to the people, taking people who don't know how to use data portals, but are just everyday people on the street, and taking them through creating visualizations and charts off of our data portals. I think it'll be a great 4-week, 6-week type of thing. We get elected officials come in to give a certificate at the end, and it's a great sense of accomplishment. You've probably seen it with EMS portal, EMS academies or police academies, and just general Civic 101 academies. I'd like to take it to data. I think that'd be a great idea, and I think this is a place to start that type of discussion. Thanks.
Hi, I'm Andy Pettish with a project called Vacant to Vital V2V. And what we're looking to do is take open source, open data and open source tools to create a mapping platform for land seekers, land activators, to connect with land owners and be able to activate, utilize underperforming properties around Wake County and turn those into vibrant spaces for that impact the community and engage everybody while that property would otherwise be sitting vacant and taking away from what the community could have there, the potential for it to realize that potential. We want to create that mapping tool. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Jim Scarborough. Last year I gave a GitHub 101 talk, and I'll do it again this year if y'all want me to. Only if you came last year, it'll be different, because I've learned a few more tricks. So I'll turn the table a little bit and gear it towards the audience, and it'll be good.
And now that I've heard everyone else's, I'm going to do this one because I want to go all the other ones. But I'd love to join the gentleman who was talking about sustainability of brigades. I'd also love to have a conversation about how or should the Code for America national network do things together as a group more. So we've got our national day civic hacking, we've got Code Across. Should there be more activities that go across the network?
Adam Martin, back again, Sydney Raleigh. We have a philosophy around getting data out to people, not just in our portals, so I talked about that earlier, but also getting data to people where they want it and where they need it. So we have road closures going out to Waze and Google Maps, things like that. We have all kinds of alerting tools. There's Twitter, we have our social media manager here. There's email blasts. There's a Code for America project called CityGram that is currently active in the Triangle, which gives alerts to folks based on their location around crime and permits. So we have all these tools for doing push and alerts of data, and I want to basically have a conversation about what's your use case, what's your specific need, where do you want to get alerts from the city that you're not already getting them that could be powered by the data. Thanks.
Hello, my name is Frank Jones, and I'd like to talk about how we can use Wikipedia Editathons to be able to cite some of the data and the visualizations that are being created, and be able to get that information out into more people's hands. Wikipedia is already a resource that people are turning to for information, and that information is already open. So it makes sense to partner up in getting that data and visualizations out there.
Hi, I'm Jim Scarborough. I want to talk about Twitter carpool matching. So what's the idea? You put your origin and your destination in Twitter, and you say about when you're going to go, and then somebody else can search for that. Oh my God. And it solves a whole lot of problems with ride matching that we have in the United States, especially the invisibility of all the various platforms. So that's Twitter carpool matching.
Hi, Ken Hunter again. The other one is ask the budget and finance office. For those of you who are doing anything that has to do with apps or anything else, if you're working on where you're kind of wondering about government, particularly local level financial data, or if you simply want to gripe at somebody who works in local government finance, I can't obviously speak for all jurisdictions, and I certainly am not going to say anything negative or anything like that, but I'm happy to listen. It basically is just a Q&A.
Hi, I'm Jim Scarborough. I would like to have a conversation about using a weather radio with a Raspberry Pi specifically for tornado warnings, specifically for your location. Because since 2007, the National Weather Service has been issuing storm-based warnings, which use polygons, which are much smaller than the political boundaries that they used to use. And why are we not using that to alert schools, offices, cities, other areas? That's what we need to do. I'll have a conversation about that. I've done a whole lot of development on this already, so the interesting part is, where do we go next? Hi, I'm Jim Scarborough. And I would like to talk to you about OPEN511 road closure data. Ian and I talked about this a while ago, and we did some work on it. What it has turned into is writing a very straightforward adapter to convert between OPEN511 and the Waze road closure data. And if you can just convert between Waze and OPEN511, then everybody can have all their data and everybody's happy because you can convert it into every different format. So let's bring the data that Raleigh has made available by Waze and other places have made available by Waze into the OPEN511 format, so that it can be translated every which way.
Hi,
I'm not Jim Scarborough. And we only have 4 time slots, so if we had another one, we'd have to choose. Okay, this is your last chance while I'm gonna delay install. If you have an idea you want to do a pitch, we've got about 24-ish pitches so far. So I think we'll be able to get to all of them. It just matters on how we order them. So, but in order to make that order, we need your input. So I'm going to ask everyone to come up and vote in a moment. We'll have markers out. Just put a tick mark in the nice green voting box that we've provided. Again, you have up to 4 votes. You can spread them out or you can stack them. Jim, you should vote on, you can only vote 4 times. So that's 1 of each of your. Any questions that we can address? If you're a newcomer, we want to make sure that you are well taken care of. If you don't want to ask in public, find someone with a yellow shirt and we can help you out. So, by the way, is lunch here yet?
Yes.
Do we know? Lunch is here? Okay. So what we'd like you to do is to come up from this side and go that way, and then go back around to kind of, we have some, a little bit of organization there. And then you can go grab your lunch, and then you're going to want to be back in your seats at 12:30 because we've got a cool presentation from Esri, so you don't want to miss that. So let's go vote.